Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen from the media. My name is Kira Christian D. Azucena. I'm the Assistant Secretary of the Office of the United Nations and International Organizations, or UNEO of DFA. Yes. And my office manages and coordinates the Philippines' engagements with the United Nations, including the country's participation in the United Nations General Assembly, or UNGA. The President will travel to New York next week to participate in the opening of the 77th session of the UN General Assembly. He will deliver the Philippine National Statement at the high-level general debate of the opening, and his speaking slot is approximately 3:15 in the afternoon of day one. That's Tuesday, September 20, 2022. The theme of this year's general debate is a watershed moment, transformative solutions to interlocking challenges. We can expect the President's statement to identify these challenges and the solutions to address them, the role of the United Nations, and how the Philippines intends to contribute to these efforts. The President's statement will also articulate his administration's priorities, which includes climate change, the rule of law, and food security. Around 152 other heads of state and government will participate in the high-level general debate. The President will take this opportunity to meet with some of them during his stay in New York. He will also meet with some key United Nations officials. The President's participation in the opening of UNGA 77 is important because it marks his first engagement with the United Nations, which the Philippines recognizes as the world's most important multilateral organization. In the UN's program of activities, the high-level general debate is the most important event politically because this is where world leaders articulate policy statements on world affairs and international relations. It is extensively covered by global media and monitored by policy analysts, governments, academics, and CSOs. This year's general debate is also significant because it is the first one to be held completely in person since the pandemic hit in 2020. The general debates in 2020 and 2021 were virtual, where statements were delivered via pre-recorded videos. Former President Duterte participated in the last two general debates through a pre-recorded video. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador Daza, and good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon, Secretary Angeles. So thank you, ASEC Kira, for the briefing on the President's participation at the 77th UN General Assembly this year. As we all know, the President is very focused on the economy. So coming out of the COVID-19 pandemic and with much uncertainty and disruption around us, the President is not sparing any effort to address the economic challenges facing the country today. The President has made it very clear from the initial discussions preparatory to this trip to New York that it will be more than his debut on the world stage. He gave unequivocal instructions that his meetings, whether with fellow world leaders or with U.S. corporations, should focus on finding the necessary partnerships or synergies that will benefit the Philippine economy and the Filipino people. As such, the other most important speech that the President will deliver in New York, aside from his UNGA address, will be at an economic briefing. This briefing is expected to attract institutional investors, senior corporate executives, business analysts, and even academics, think tanks, and entrepreneurs. This briefing will be an opportunity to outline the key economic priorities of his administration, with a special focus on how we can hopefully expand and strengthen Philippine-U.S. trade and investment relations during his term. At this briefing, the economic managers will also speak to some of the macroeconomic and sectoral issues that might be of interest to potential U.S. investors and partners. We expect them to be joined by a couple of Philippine private sector leaders. The President will then participate in CEO roundtables on targeted sectors. These roundtables are designed to project the Philippines as an important emerging economy and investment destination in Asia. Present will be companies that are operating in the Philippines and with expansion plans, as well as those who are planning to invest in the country in the near future. On the other hand, we expect the one-on-one business meetings of the President to deal with priority areas that can engender a quick, post-pandemic economic recovery and the long-term resilience of the Philippine economy. The President intends to meet with U.S. companies that will be able to contribute to our efforts to achieve food security, energy security, and sustainable economic development, among others. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, the President is expected to meet with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, the U.S. ASEAN Business Council, and the U.S. Philippine Society. At these engagements, he will be able to have wide-ranging and candid discussions with political, business, and community leaders on raising the profile of the Philippines in the United States, contributing to the President's economic agenda, and strengthening Philippine-U.S. political, economic, and cultural ties. I'll stop here. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much to our assistant secretaries from the Department of Foreign Affairs. Yusek Reggie, may please begin the question and answer portion, the questioning portion.
So, who'd like to ask a question?
Yusek,
Ivan Marina, okay.
Magandang hapon po sa lahat. Pwede pong malaman kung sino ang magiging bahagi ng official delegation ng Pangulo?
I think this may be answered by the DFA.
Thank you for the question. If I may answer it, as part of the presidential delegation, presidential engagement with the United Nations, we had to submit a letter of credentials for the Philippine delegation. And in that list, which is quite long, we do have a number of cabinet secretaries included, as well as a number of undersecretaries and other support staff representing the different government agencies, which include the Department of Foreign Affairs, Department of Trade and Industry, the Department of Finance, NEDA, and other the Department of Migrant Workers, and other agencies. I don't have the list with me, but that's essentially the composition and the letter of credentials. I also know that there is quite a substantial business delegation. I leave that to ASEC JV to address. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, ASEC Kira. Well, just to confirm that indeed there will be a about a 20 to 30 member business delegation composed of senior Philippine corporate executives who will be joining the President in New York for this particular trip. I'll leave that to, I think, DTI or the Palace to issue the final list of business delegates who will be accompanying the President. Thank you.
Ito na lamang po. Naikasa po ba ang meeting in the sidelines with U.S. President Joe Biden at sino-sino pa po mga world leaders kaya ang na-arrange na makakapulong ng Pangulo?
DFA, please.
Thank you for the question. Well, I'll just speak to the specific issue about President Biden. We're still in consultations with the White House and of course the National Security Council in Washington D.C. Ambassador Maldes is personally dealing with the matter, and I would understand that if there's going to be any announcement, it will probably come either from Secretary Manalo or from Ambassador Maldes, and obviously that will have to be coordinated with the White House as well. Thank you.
Okay. Our next question is from Tristan Lodelo of TNN Philippines.
Hi, good afternoon po. Follow-up ko lang po doon sa topics that will be covered by the President's speech sa UNGA. As you mentioned po kanina, may mga ilang general topics na. But in the last two UNGA of President Duterte, he na-highlight po doon yung position on the South China Sea and the arbitral ruling. Are we also expecting that there will be this assertion as well from President Marcos na i-bring niya po sa international community itong issue po on the South China Sea? Thank you.
DFA.
Thank you. Thank you, Trixie, and thank you for the question. In the draft statement that the DFA prepared for the president, there is a very strong section on the rule of law and the role of the UNCLOS. But of course, the way these things go, the statements and speeches of the president are usually vetted by the office of the president. So beyond that, I cannot offer any further comments. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.
Okay, next question from Ms. Celerina Monte of NHK.
Good afternoon po. I have a few questions, like follow up on Ivan Mayorina's question. Aside from President Biden, who could be the other of presidents whom are heads of state that the president would be having a bilateral meetings? Would that include Japanese Prime Minister Kishida?
DFA, we'll add to that, but I would like the DFA to answer first.
Thank you, Sec, and thank you for the question. What I can say at this point is that we do have a number of confirmed meetings at the leaders' level involving the president, but we are not inclined to disclose at this point kung sino po yung mga kausap niya. But definitely, once the meetings have been conducted, there will be a statement, a press release on these meetings as soon as they're done. Thank you.
Just to double check po, so from when up to when the president will be in New York, and will it be only in New York, not in any other states po in the U.S.?
There are no plans for any other. The primary purpose will still be the UN General Assembly, and that is the main purpose of the trip. There are no announcements or no calendared activities other than that, and those congruent or collateral to this address. Well, of course, aside from what he usually does, meeting with the Filipino community when the opportunity arises. Would the DFA like to add?
No, ma'am. Thank you.
Pero yung dates po, from when up to when? He will be delivering the speech on the 20th, but when will he leave and when will he come back to the Philippines?
I understand that he leaves the Philippines on the 18th and will return, if I'm not mistaken, DFA, please confirm, on the 24th. DFA, is it? I got my dates right. All right, that's it. He leaves the Philippines on the 18th, returns on the 24th, leaves New York on the 24th.
Thank you.
Thank you, Telarina. And next is from Hannah Jane Sancho of SMN.
Good afternoon, everyone. Confirm ko lang po, hindi pa sure yung Filipino community na meeting na hindi pa possible yung or hindi pa sure na magkakaroon ng meeting si President Marcos sa Filipino community dito sa New York.
We'll be making an announcement on the details at a later date.
All right. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, next question is from Donna Pazibugan of Inquirer.
I won't ask my questions anymore. They've been covered. Thank you.
Okay. Next is Job Manahan of ABS-CBN News Online.
Good afternoon po. I would just ask lang po if President Marcos would meet with China Xi Jinping po. And follow up ko lang din po yung kung possible din po na makakapag-meet with Fumio Kishida ng Japan po. Thank you.
For meetings, we are not at liberty to make any announcements, particularly since we will be making final announcements when we get to New York as the occasion arises. So I hope you understand.
Okay po. Just follow-up question lang po. What are the topics that President Marcos will discuss during UNGA? And ano po yung possible na erase niya kung may kipag-meet siya sa ibang bilateral leaders, sa iba pong leaders?
Well, in general, we don't announce the details of a speech until actually it's been made. No? But in this case, the president's primary objective, and in fact his main policy in his governance, in this administration, is economic recovery. And so all activities, particularly even those that are related, all presidential activities are related to this particular vision. So we're going to expect that his speech will be relating to how the Philippines will be recovering from this pandemic and where he intends to take this and how he will do so in cooperation with other states. Are you okay?
Yes, po. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Job. And next is Barnaby Loh of Algeria.
Good afternoon, ma'am, sir. I just want to follow up on Celerina's question earlier about the itinerary. So he's leaving on the 18th. May we know the time and what kind of coverage arrangements will there be at the airport? As well as clarification lang on the time of the speech. It's 3:15 p.m. September 20th. That's East Coast time, right? So that would be 3:15 a.m. Wednesday in the Philippines.
DFA, with regard to the time of the speech, could you please clarify?
Thank you, ma'am, and thank you for the question. The president will speak, he's speaker number two on day one of the afternoon session of the general debate, which means that, and the afternoon session usually starts at 3 o'clock. And world leaders who will deliver their respective statements are usually given courtesy time limit, courtesy, I emphasize the word courtesy, time limit of 20 minutes. But of course, if they go beyond 20 minutes, then nobody's in a position to stop them. So that's why I said in my opening statement that the estimated time of delivery of the president's statement at the general debate is around 3:15 to 3:20 in the afternoon New York time. Thank you.
Your time, okay.
Okay. Now, let's move on to for the question of Ms. Malu of Business Mirror.
Hi, magandang hapon po. Can you hear me?
Yes, loud and clear, ma'am.
Okay. Secretary Trixie, I gathered the Vice President is scheduled to have also a meeting, an education summit meeting. But is she pushing through? Because I heard that the schedule is supposed to be September 17 to 19.
I'm afraid you're going to have to refer to the Department of Education for these details.
All right. But of course, it does, the president and the vice president are not allowed to go.
And that was the Malacañang press briefing with the Department of Foreign Affairs to discuss President Bongbong Marcos's incoming visit to New York from September 18 to 24 next week for the 77th United Nations General Assembly. It will be the president's debut on the world stage. And DFA ASEC Kira Danganan Azuzena has confirmed that his speaking slot would be 3:15 p.m. of day one, that's Tuesday, September 20, 2022. During the visit, she has also mentioned where there are at least 152 heads of state that will be attending. He will be meeting some of them, though it is not yet in detail on who will it be. Aside from the UNGA, the president will also be attending the economic briefing, as mentioned by ASEC Jose Victor Chan Gonzaga. President Marcos is also expected to meet with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, the U.S. ASEAN Business Council, and the U.S. Philippine Society during this trip. More details, including who will be included in his official delegation, is to be announced in the coming days.